John? John? He's starting to come out. John, can you hear me? You're in a hospital. You were in an accident. I don't want you to try to move.
It's
right
okay,
now.
John. It's okay. The kids and I are fine.
John, you got banged up pretty good.
Go!
High school football accounts for nearly 47% of all reported sports concussions, with 33% occurring during practice. Some studies cite nearly 1 in 5 high school athletes will sustain a sports-related concussion during a season. Concussion numbers are becoming staggering. There are some 4 to 5 million concussions suffered annually, and the highest rise in that number is from middle school athletes. To say that these numbers are alarming is an understatement, but behind many of these numbers, there is an athlete who has been affected. Sadly, in some cases, a life has been lost.
I got headaches, I felt nausea. Whenever I looked into the lights, my head started to hurt. Just felt really dizzy, tired.
So I felt like I was really dizzy. Everything was loud, everything was bright. It was kind of like overwhelming. As if I was kind of like...
I think 7 to, let's see, like 7 to 12.
Playing football for SU. And I remember we were doing practice lines. And I remember I just got hit in the head. And then I went for another practice line. And I got hit in the head again, really hard. So I knew I felt really off. So I got checked out the next day, and then I found out that I had a concussion. And then the second
I was water skiing, I was slalom skiing, and just caught an edge and went down and hit my head on the water.
It took me about, I got it on a Monday, and then I found out on a Tuesday, and then I was off from school for the next 3 days, so I came back to school the following Monday. And by the time I felt really 100% was probably maybe 2 weeks after. But I didn't play football after that. I stopped playing football.
Still want a snowboard.
You actually could die.
Were you aware of all the treatments that were available to you?
No.
Right.
The first time, no, I had no idea of anything that really existed. I had to like search around and ask other friends that had concussions like mine. And then the second time and the third time, I went back to the same person who already knew me, obviously. So at the time, no, I had no idea there was anything like there was. So it's not great, but there's something like it.
No, I wasn't aware of any of them. I remember I got it, and then I just remember saying I was excused from class. So I just didn't come for the next 3 days, but I didn't, when I came back to school on Monday, I felt it was like a normal class.
Last fall revealed that ER admission rates for children with sports-related head injuries has increased by more than 90% in the last decade.
Next tonight, the autopsy results after that Friday Night Lights tragedy.
New concussion concerns tonight coming from the American Academy of Neurology.
The San Francisco 49ers over concerns about the long-term effects of
high school quarterback.
The NFL's concussion crisis was hard to ignore.
Recent media focus and investigations have placed big hits on the front page.
Well, now that you've had more than one concussion, did you notice a difference in like the healing process between like your first and your second one, even though it was worse?
Because I knew a lot more about concussions, so it was easier to like know. Because before my first concussion, I didn't know that you weren't supposed to look like watch TV or anything or play video games. So I did that a lot, but after I got like when I got my first concussion, the doctor told me. And they told me, so the second one I was a lot more careful. I was always in my room in the dark and stuff.
So you learned a lot more through your second one?
Yes.
I felt like it went by, as I said, the first concussion was 2 weeks, then a week and a half, and a few days, so I feel like it really went down a lot?
Well, my second one, I knew how to handle it. I knew no TV, no electronics. So in a way, I had like more knowledge and I knew how he was gonna feel. But regarding like the symptoms and stuff, it probably took the same amount of time, 2 weeks to feel like 100%. But after your first few days, you start feeling better. You feel more like yourself. So the symptoms aren't very strong after the first few days.
No, I paid for like this one thing just to strengthen my neck or something. Didn't really work that great though.
I think so. So you go to, there's always specialists that are that much more money, or you can go here or there, but there's a price on them, you know what I mean? So like, I feel like if I had the most money in the world, I'd go to a lot more specialists and maybe be a bit healthier, faster.
Concussions are now a part of the grade 9 health curriculum because my grade 11s were not in grade 9 during when this change was made. I taught it to the grade 11s this year as well. So yeah, it's in the curriculum, and as of next year, everyone will get it because grade 9 health is mandatory.
How long do you spend on concussions in class?
I spent probably a full class of the health unit that I put it into, and the discussion kind of spilled over into a second class because when we put it into the, we discussed it in the opening meeting for boys football. I don't talk about it explicitly at the beginning of the girls' season, but what we like to say, because there's a lot of fear around concussions, and we have kids coming into grade 9 who have never had a concussion that say, I don't want to play, my parents don't want me to play football because they don't want me to get a concussion. And so we just like to reassure them that there are procedures in place that prevent us from putting them at risk. So when a kid says the C word, the concussion word, or has any symptoms, we immediately give them a blue form, which is the TDSB concussion protocol. And that has to be signed off twice by doctors before they return to play.
More and more studies are coming out saying even repetitive headers are damaging the brain. When you scan a soccer player's brain, it no longer looks like the average person.
Peewee hockey today is not the peewee hockey we played when we were kids.
The level of violence would give a reasonable person pause.
Rugby aficionados say you can't compare rugby with NFL. Research done shows that there is a slightly higher incidence of concussion in rugby than there is in American football.
This is a public health issue. Yes, there are some things happening at the professional level, but what if similar things are happening for kids?
Personally, if I had a six-year-old out there playing football, I would be freaked out, and I think rightly so. Because you're playing Russian roulette with their future.
Well, I think that RSU is like a really big school in sports, especially. So, if anything, they should have a lot of like access to stuff like that. But maybe private schools, maybe they have special doctors that they have at their own school, or nurses that we don't have here at public schools like RSU. So maybe that would be a good thing to have, but we don't have access to that.
Yes. Well, like they do pay. We don't even, like, our schools, we don't have to pay for any, so they should get special things, but, like, all schools should have, like, little things, like a concussion room or something, just little things, not, like, the big things that, like, these schools, like, big schools like St. Mike's have, but, like, small things that will, like, make up.
I don't really have a big problem with it, but I feel like there is a bit of a, not fairness, if that's a word, there, because, obviously, the more high-income schools will have more money to spend on treatments and stuff like that, whereas the low-income schools maybe have lower-income families that can't afford as much. Kind of. Do you think?
Where do you think the money should come from in order to pay for healthcare like that, like the tax money or individually?
Individually.
Both from the TDSB and students, because students also have to help, because like it's for us, so we have to pay, but TDSB major, like, they should majorly pay for it, because they should take care of us students, so.
I think there's enough medical professionals that we have access to that I don't think schools need them per chance, and nurses wouldn't be qualified to diagnose that kind of stuff. So I think we're fine as long as we understand the protocol and keeping kids
out. I think any school with a football program should definitely do it. Well, it's not as prevalent in like baseball or other sports, so schools that don't have a strong sports program, they wouldn't necessarily have to, but like schools that have football programs and rugby programs and basketball and soccer, those are even higher level concussion sports, I think you should definitely have them, because you don't even know when you have one sometimes.